Welcome to This Is My Architecture. I'm Matt from AWS. We're in Las Vegas on the third day of AWS reInvent, and I'm here with Paul from SkyScanner. Thanks for joining.
Hi there.
So tell us about SkyScanner.
Hi, yeah, we're a travel search company. We're based in the UK, and we have about 80 million unique users a month.
Wow, 80 million. So you need a lot of infrastructure to support
it. We do. We have a lot of infrastructure to support that.
It makes your job fun.
All on AWS.
Awesome. Yeah. Thank you. So I see you have a Kubernetes cluster up here. I was thinking about this video series, and 2 years ago, roughly, when we started, a couple of customers were talking about Kubernetes and containers, but it was still kind of getting started for a lot of them. Fast forward to this video shoot, and it seems like every second video we're doing is about containers and about Kubernetes and EKS, ECS. So I guess it's good to see, and I think a lot of our viewers are going to appreciate the tips you give them today.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, there's definitely a lot of buzz about containers at this reInvent.
So the first thing I noticed is, you know, this is Kubernetes cluster, and we were talking before, and you were saying you're running this on EC2. So we have EKS, and you know, there's other ways you can run Kubernetes. A lot of ways you can run Kubernetes in the cloud. Why did you do it this way?
Yeah, we did it this way because we were maybe 6 to 7 months. Before
was even
announced, so I think we made a decision to move to Kubernetes just before EKS was public knowledge. So we decided to plow ahead ourselves.
Okay, and I see here you have sort of, are these representing availability zones or?
Yeah. So what this represents is the underlying infrastructure for a typical Kubernetes cluster at SkyScanner, and what makes our infrastructure slightly different is the fact we're running on Spot.
Spot instances,
okay. 100% on Spot.
100% Spot, okay. Yeah, that's going to be interesting for a lot of people.
Yeah.
So I see ASG, so those are auto-scaling groups spanning multiple availability zones, is it?
Yeah, so I mean, it's an individual ASG being deployed across multiple AZs is a fairly normal setup for a Kubernetes cluster. However, what we do is we have multiple ASGs. So we have two here, but typically we have five ASGs. And what that gives us is it gives us diversification in the spot pool.
So diversification of instance type?
Yes, of instance type. So we run C3s, C4s, C5s, M4s, R3s in our clusters.
Great, because I guess with diversification with Spot, so that way if there's not enough available capacity for one, you can use another
exactly,
more
yeah.
of another?
Yeah, well with Spot, you've got pools of capacity per instance type per AZ. So
yeah.
the more unique pools of capacity you pull from, the less likelihood that you'll lose all of your capacity in your cluster at any one time.
And what kind of scale are we talking? You know, are these really big instance types? You said 80 million users. How does that translate
so
to
national? We run multiple clusters across multiple regions.
Okay.
Within an individual cluster, we are potentially sort of 120, 130 nodes at peak.
Oh, wow.
Typically sort of C8X, 9X class instance types.
Okay, so C5, C4s,
yeah,
M5s,
yeah.
The big ones.
Yeah. So you're talking maybe sort of 3,500, 4,000 cores at peak.
Yeah. Okay. Wow. Okay. And how many sort of queries are you getting? What kind of volume is this supporting?
Yeah. So we typically at peak on a single cluster in one of our busier regions, it'll be between 60,000 to 70,000 queries per second.
Wow. Okay. So 60,000 to 70,000 queries per second.
Yep.
80 million users. That's a lot of volume. I imagine handling that is not for the faint of heart. So, how are you sort of handling scaling with Spot, 100% Spot in your Kubernetes cluster?
Yeah, so I think it really goes down to diversification.
Okay.
Because we have multiple AZs with multiple different instance types across multiple clusters in multiple regions, we're essentially broadening out that pool of capacity. And because we're using AWS infrastructure, I mean, the actual managing of the instances is really handled by the ASGs. The cluster autoscaler is the piece that's manipulating the desired count on multiple ASGs. In the cluster autoscaler, it refers to an ASG as a node group. That's how it collects instances of the same type together and then presents that back to the rest of the Kubernetes infrastructure to make use.
So when you said desired count, you mean desired count of nodes of EC2 instances?
Yes, yeah, okay. within an individual ASG.
Okay, great. So is there anything that you think viewers would find interesting or might learn from your experience using 100% Spot in this case for a Kubernetes cluster?
Yeah, so I think the first thing you have to deal with is the Spot termination.
Okay.
So that's something you can't avoid. So we have a shutdown script which will it will cordon the node, so it prevents prevents the Kubernetes scheduler from actually pushing more pods.
So when you get that 2-minute termination notification,
yeah.
How does it actually know that the node is going to be terminated?
Yeah, so every 5 seconds, there's an R script which runs and it checks the metadata.
The instance metadata,
instance metadata. It sees the termination notice. It then kicks off the script to cordon the node, and then it deregisters it from the ELB, and then it drains the node completely.
Okay, and how does it actually prevent new traffic from going to the node?
So our setup is slightly different in that we run our HA proxy ingress controllers across all of the nodes in the clusters. That gives us quite a high degree of resilience in terms of inbound traffic to the clusters.
Okay.
So we simply unregister the instance from the ELB. That stops traffic coming in from the outside.
Okay, great. So you handle both like the unregistration from the ELB, but also like Kubernetes is aware that the node is going
to go away. We have to tell the ELB to stop sending traffic, but we also have to tell Kubernetes to treat this node as being unavailable and to stop scheduling workloads onto it and to gracefully drain the services that are still running on it.
Are there any gotchas with this approach, or just with taking nodes out that you've learned along the way?
Not specifically. I mean, I think the different piece is the fact that we have HA proxy instances running on all of our nodes, so we have to have this extra step to drain the ELB. But apart from that, it's the standard Kubernetes commands that we're running.
Okay. And did anything as you were building this sort of not work as expected, or did you have to make any changes?
Yes, we encountered a feature with the cluster autoscaler, which prevented it from autoscaling when a single ASG reached zero.
Okay.
The cluster autoscaler relies on at least one node being in the autoscaling pool to allow it to describe it, to actually figure out what type of resources it has available.
All right.
And it's entered an edge case where it can handle that. And we got into a situation where we had to restart the cluster autoscaler every so often.
Okay, so how did you fix it?
We applied a patch, which Zalando built, which was great. That's solved that problem.
Well, okay, that's a great tip for viewers watching out there who might be restarting their cluster autoscaler.
Yes, yeah.
And so I guess one more question. We were talking about your use of Spot, which I think is great in autoscaling groups. Some user or some viewers watching this might be thinking, why aren't they using reserved instances instead? Why the Spot approach?
Well, we felt that because of the diversification factor, the multiple clusters, the multiple regions, we could take advantage of the full saving that we could get from Spot.
Because they're so much cheaper.
They're considerably cheaper, yeah. And they're considerably cheaper than reserved instances as well.
Oh, so you're actually able to get like cheaper than reserved instances.
Yes, it was cheaper overall. As it worked out, it's been cheaper, and it also gives us the flexibility of being able to use different instance types. We're relatively new to this level of scale with Kubernetes, so we still didn't feel that we had seen all the different types of workloads that we'd have in this Kubernetes cluster. So using reserved instances, we might have picked the wrong instance type, and that would just have it would have been harder for us to deal with different workloads as we move forward.
Okay, well that's great. I think a lot of viewers watching this, it's going to resonate with them. The fact that you're running at such scale across multiple regions, you know, not just multiple AZs, multiple regions, and that you're really using 100% Spot. I think it'll help people overcome that initial barrier sometimes when they think about it.
Yeah, I mean, I think that's the thing with Spot is that the actual technical solution wasn't that complicated to roll out, especially with support from the AWS SAs. I think it's more about understanding the risk and approaching it from that sort of perspective and making sure that you're comfortable with the risk and you have ways to mitigate it. I mean, we have runbooks to switch back to on-demand if that becomes a problem.
Okay, it's always good to have a backup plan.
Yes, indeed.
Well, great, I really like this architecture. I think a lot of people will appreciate it, so thanks for sharing with us.
Welcome.
And thanks for watching. This is My Architecture.